installation process, the module, that is the modular object-oriented dynamic learning environment. It asks for the copyright notice. Yes, you can read those instructions and select continue. So now the installation of module 3.7.6 plus is getting started up. Of course, if at all, if you find any difficulty here, that's what my earlier experience tells, that there will be some checks which are not undergone properly, then you have to install the necessary packages. Luckily, now all the checks were shows that they are okay, and you can simply select continue. So the installation step is under progress. The installation is related to the Moodle software getting installed onto the LAMP stack. This may take a couple of minutes to complete the installation. So once the installation has been completed, you can as well see these are the set of success checks which have been shown to us. If at all you have any difficulty, please contact me. I can help you in installing the necessary packages. I can as well connect to your system remotely and check and install the necessary packages for you. See, there are so many packages that's getting installed here. So these are all the necessary softwares that has to be installed for your Moodle. So the last step you get is a continue button to complete the installation process. If you don't get a continue button but with errors, then you need to troubleshoot for solving those errors. Otherwise, you can continue to the next step. A couple of instructions to be completed here. So here at the time of installation, it is asking for the admin user. So by default, admin user comes into picture. You can as well set a password for the admin. So here the same password I am giving it, so that there won't be any confusion for the passwords. So you can, whatever the minimum things are there, you can as well complete the set of steps. The minimum, set the time zone to the Kolkata, which is under the Asian category here. Yeah. Country, please select India. Yes, once you are done with this one, you can just update the admin. You can as well save it. I think there is some error here. Yes, password must have at least one uppercase. So it is not following the policy requirements of the password. So I am setting a new password for this. once you have given the password, you can update the admin, and if everything goes fine, we can go to the next step. Yes, now it is asking for the site names. I'm giving something like NKS courses. These are basically your websites. Your Moodle website front page information. Welcome to the courses website. You can as well customize this at the later stage. At this time, just with a few information, I am trying to go to the next steps to complete the installation. Set the time zone. You can save it. The email, no reply. You can as well put it as a blank. And later you can change it once the application is done. So you just save the changes. Yes, congratulations, we have completed our installation of Moodle. And you can see this is the dashboard, the site home. As of now, it is empty. The available courses are not there. You can set the calendar. These are the default values, the private files, the site administration. So here, you can see login. There's a admin has been logged in here. The name. This is your dashboard of the admin. So this is how you are trying to install the Moodle onto your LAMP stack. So this is the interface and all the steps is all about. I'm just logging out. So once you're logged out, your screen looks like this. This is the web page that you have been made for. So now let us complete the installation. A few more steps. Once you've done the installation using this interface, the last steps to be done is that make sure the path of the web is going to be a restricted access. For this, change the command change mode to the Moodle's directory command to 0755. And once you have done this one, yes, configuration is completed now, and a few more steps so that the user Moodle can be used very effectively. You need to set up an antivirus solution and some of the system paths so that the users can access the folders very efficiently without waiting for much time. So for this, what I suggest to you is you can as well once again log in to your Moodle website. Once you logged into your Moodle website, go to the site administration. Under the site administration, please scroll down. You can see there is a server configurations to be done. Under the server, you can see there is system paths. If the system paths are set properly, then several users who are using this interface can access very fastly. So you are setting the DU path. The DU path can be slash usr slash bin slash DU. Then similarly, aspl path slash usr slash bin slash aspl. Then coming to the dot path, the dot path remains as well under the user bin dot. Yes, once you have assigned these values, save all the changes. Yes, the changes have been saved. Now to have an antivirus solution, go to the command prompt. Go to your home directory. So once again, I'm opening the terminal path. So go to the terminal, then create sudo mk directory slash var slash quarantine, a folder you are creating under the var directory so that this particular folder will keep track of if there is any quarantines are to be done, because several users may try to play with the system, and to avoid that, you can secure your system by keeping track of all the garbage values onto your quarantine folder. So for this, I am creating a quarantine folder and assigning the permissions to that. Once you are given the quarantine folder permissions, go to the site administration once again and go to the plugins. Once the plugins, then antivirus plugins, go to the antivirus plugins, manage antivirus plugins. Then under this, there will be clam av, the antivirus. You need to just enable that. So once you have clicked that enable option, now it's enabled. So you can as well set the settings, otherwise you can just enable to the default settings. So the default settings, you are at the running command, at the command prompt, treat files as okay and click save. And that's it. We have completed the website, little bit of with minimal configuration steps. The Moodle website is ready to use. Thank you.